This is Game Informer's Replay. I'm Andrew Reiner, and today we have a very special episode. This game, Oddworld Stranger's Wrath, was picked by the Overblood group on Facebook, which goes by the name I Watched the Entire Overblood Super Replay. It's a strange name, but it's a great community. I highly recommend you go check it out. Today we have kind of a strange cast. We have Ben Hansen.
Hello.
You're rarely on the mics. We always want you on the mic. You're like, no, I'm too busy.
We'll find out why in this episode. It's going to be fun.
You're what make this a strange cast, by the way.
I know. Trust me, I know that.
That's Joe Juba.
I'm Joe. Hi.
And then all the way at the end of the table, if you could see a table with four dudes sitting at it, there's Daniel Tack.
That's right. I'm here.
How's it going, dude?
I'm great, and I am super excited for this game.
Awesome. Have you played this game, Daniel?
I've seen it before, but I have not actually played it.
All right.
Do you know anything about the Oddworld series at all?
No.
Wait, no, hold
Wait
on.
Wait a minute.
Those were PC games. They did come out on PC, right?
Yes, absolutely.
They were just never on my radar. I know they're looked upon with...
That's an elitist attitude. It's like, if it came out on console first, I'm not playing it.
Unless it's Dark Souls.
Yeah, there are plenty of games on console that I like on PC, so...
All right. How much do you know about Abe's Odyssey?
Zero.
Do you know the main character's name?
Is it Abe?
Do you know the creator's name?
No.
Okay. Lorne Lanning, right?
Yep. Yeah, Lorne Lanning. He's the CEO, president. He also does a lot of the voice work in this. Most of the voices.
Oh, I didn't know that.
As Hansen just brought up, Abe's Odyssey was the first one. Then there was Abe's Exodus, which was the second one, followed up by Munch's Odyssey
on Xbox. But originally, it was so annoying. It was originally going to be released on PS2, and I was really looking forward to that game, and I bought my PS2 for that, and then they switched over to Xbox.
Oh,
I had to buy one of those crappy things.
And it was the launch title for the original Xbox. And the original games were like side-scrolling. The Abe's games were side-scrolling kind of puzzle games.
Mm-hmm. Munch's Odyssey is where I fell off on the series because it moved...
A lot of people did.
Yeah, because it moved from this like... It was a lot more of a sort of like one hit and you're dead. There is a correct way to do this puzzle kind of approach. Right. And in Munch's Odyssey, it went 3D and you had like a health bar so you could get shot a little bit, but not too much.
Covered in Sobe advertisements.
Oh, yeah. What?
Yeah, they had Sobe machines in that game.
Yeah, that's right.
Also, fun fact about Munch's Odyssey, which is not the game we're playing today, a consultant designer on that game was one Jonathan Blow.
Really?
Yes,
wow.
That's true.
Look at us. We're a knowledge well.
I'm learning a lot here today.
So, Oddworld Stranger's Wrath was another departure for the series. It's more of a first-person shooter. It does have a third-person element, which we'll go through as we play this. I'm playing the game, so it's going to be a flawless run. First Triner at the sticks.
This looks cool. I've always wanted to check this out. It came out really late, didn't it?
So, yeah, we're not looking at the original Xbox version. We're actually looking at the HD remake, which just recently came out. And, boy, it looks super nice.
Yeah. But, I mean, this was a good-looking game back on Xbox
originally.
It was,
yeah. Too. I mean, this is a higher-res version of a good-looking game with better lighting.
Yeah. Now, this is one I don't want to... I don't want to tread into... dangerous territory here, but one of the things I remember about this game is that it has a twist to it, and it's not quite... This isn't the style of game that you play and you expect some sort of big plot twist on it.
Twist not being that you're shooting live creatures?
No, this is the twist right... I'm doing it right now.
Yeah, Reiner is doing the twist. That's what I meant. The dance move, the twist, is in this game. The end.
Remember in the middle of KOTOR when Darth Revan starts doing the twist?
Same thing, yeah.
No, but I mean...
Well, continue, Joe. I mean, you can't just bring that up and just be like,
spoil the crap out of this game.
I don't want to spoil it. I haven't played it, so I don't know all
Joe,
of the
Joe, I command you to spoil this game. I don't know what this is.
But no, like there's some sort of thing that I remember that happens in this game that sort of blindsided people because they weren't expecting it to be a twist. I mean, Reiner, you played it. Do you remember that?
Yeah, but I don't want to spoil stuff.
Okay,
guys, this game is so old. Just spoil it.
Well, no, but there's an HD version that just came out. There are probably lots of people who didn't play it, like what? 8-9 years ago or whatever.
Don't spoil it.
So
I really
that's
think
Jason A. Stryker, by the way.
Hey, how's it going?
He's our video producer.
So yeah, we're not going to spoil it. Suffice it to say, one of the things people talk about in this game is there's a little unexpected thing.
And here's an unexpected thing.
There you go.
So you're playing the game third person, then look, whoa! First person shooter.
I remember when they first talked about this that they made a big joke out of you're firing live ammo.
Mm-hmm.
Ha ha, knee slapper.
They really have that on the back of the box too.
Yeah, good, yeah.
Because they're alive. Yeah.
But it's a cool idea. Does it mean anything? Like, do you shoot it at them and it crawls over them? Or
so this guy hates this little bastard, this chipmunk.
Okay.
And he stepped on that weak wood and died.
All right, he's just being inattentive at that point. Like, I don't care how much you hate chipmunks. That's that's on him. That's his bad.
I have a chipmunk that lives under my house, and I see him when I drive my car up. He'll be like sitting on our front stoop, and then as soon as I get out of the car, he like goes running inside. And we've been trying to kill that bastard for like the last 3 years. There might be a full family down there.
You know how you kill him is you get another chipmunk and then you put it in a slingshot and you fire that at the first chipmunk.
Wait, these are exploding chipmunks.
Correct.
Yeah. Okay. Or you'd get a garden hose in there, Reiner, and you drown them. You drown those cute little bastards.
Oh, you put it in the holes, but what if he just climbs out and then I'm just like, well, sinking my house?
You know, Reiner, back on the farm at my parents' place to kill pocket gophers,
Here's some homespun wisdom from Ben Hansen.
From Papa Don Hansen. So you take your car, preferably a Pontiac station wagon, and you hook up a hose to the exhaust, but you don't put it into the driver's seat. You put it into the hole where the pocket gophers live, and then they die peacefully.
So just, I like that.
Just shove the hose under your house and just sit in your car for 3 hours.
Yeah, that's a great idea.
And that sounds like a really bad idea.
Yeah. Is that what he told you that he was doing? Has he put the hose in your room?
That's right. Okay. Yes, yeah.
Look, first Triner goes backwards. That's how good I am.
When is this first Triner BS? When did this start?
I beat everything on the first try.
Is this a Super Replay Showdown remnant, or where is this coming from?
Nah, it started in Replay.
Okay.
And he will not let it die.
Boy.
Look, these guys are distracted.
Replay lore has changed so much since I've been here. In the dedicated replay room.
Look, I got a spider, guys.
Okay.
That's a bullamite.
Do you have to go around and, like, trap these creatures, or where are they coming from?
Yeah, you gotta actually pick up live ammo.
Okay.
So you're not going to find, like, a box of these guys. They're going to be, like, indigenous to the world.
All right.
But we're, like, in the tutorial, so.
Yeah.
But watch this.
Okay. Now, I don't know how far we're going to get, but, like, this whole game, there is a little bit of, like, a third-person, like, open world kind of, like, a hub world.
Oh, don't you worry about
that,
Joe. We're getting there.
Okay.
I'm looking forward to it.
This is a Reiner play.
All right. Look, we get your name's Reiner. We're all fully on board with that concept here. So what's interesting about this series to me is that maybe it's just my perception, but I've never thought that they've sold like crazy. But then again, it has been around for 20 years now. Maybe not that long, but a long time. I mean, when did the first one come out?
Since PS1.
Okay,
so yeah, it's been around for a long time.
Coming up on 20 years, and they've never been blockbusters. I mean, I think the first couple sold pretty well, but I always had the perception like this one in particular was kind of a flop. Did Munch's Odyssey?
I think did terrible.
So what is keeping these games around? Is it just the passion of Lauren Lanning and he always wants to come back? And
terrible. I think, you know, when they sell like a million and they're planning like 5 million or something, I think that's the version of terrible. So there is still a big fan base for them.
Yeah.
But I mean, also Hansen Define keeps these games around. I mean, you are looking right now at a remake of the most recent Oddworld.
That's right. I was just thinking about that. I mean, maybe it's just been on my mind because of the PS4 version, the new and tasty of the original Abe's Odyssey that they're re-releasing, which I'm really excited about. But I guess it has been a while since this game came out. So they've taken a little bit of a break.
You guys want to see a Stunks?
No.
Really.
No, I don't.
Aww. Look, he's puking. He's puking.
Gross. Guys. I remember
so this is the currency when you suck these guys up.
I didn't know. Okay, so you're actually like vacuuming up monsters.
So you're a vacuum bounty hunter?
Yeah.
Okay.
The twist is the stranger is Luigi.
Fantastic.
That's what I was guessing it was.
Yeah, yeah.
Reiner, I remember watching the replay of Abe's Odyssey before I started here.
Abe's Odyssey?
That's right. That's too something soon. Else entirely.
Too soon.
But you did that back in like 2010 before I started because I love that game. I'm like, oh, this game, a former replay show, covered one of my favorite games. Let's check it out.
Oh, that's cool.
So when you said you're doing Oddworld today, I went into your office because I was expecting to stump you, hoping that you wouldn't remember that you had already done Odyssey. This is this game.
These guys are cool. Watch what these little guys do. Let's see if I can get it onto this. Well, I'm glad you're here, Hansen, by the way.
You know what, Reiner? I love you too, man. And Daniel.
Okay, that guy just took a header into the off the dock of his own volition.
You don't know his life story, man.
No, he was being chased by a little furry through. Thing.
Okay.
Hey, there's Daniel Tack.
Oh, yeah, I'm here. I'm just trying to take it all in. I haven't played this, you know, any of the games in the series, so.
What do you think, Daniel? Would you play them? Does this look fun to you? Be honest.
Vaguely.
We got him on board.
Daniel, I brought you down here to have fun.
I'm having fun.
You just sit up there playing PC games all day, not having any fun whatsoever. You're only happy if your eyebrows are furrowed.
It's true.
Just smile for once.
That's a great, that's just sounds like a great song title. You're only happy when your eyebrows are furrowed?
Furrowed.
Furrowed. It's not a thing. Careful.
I want to meet the person that's the most into the Oddworld mythology. You know, there's like some forums deep somewhere on the internet where people are still debating like the overall mythology of this universe.
You should set that up, dude.
Sure, that's definitely happening.
I think it's interesting. Like, is this on the same planet that Abe's Odyssey is going on? Do you think you're going to see like the factories from Abe's Odyssey and stuff?
You should set that up. Bring your silly little camera and get it all set up and record it, and then no one will watch it.
Okay.
Hansen's never-ending search to find someone stranger than him.
That's right. The wrath of the stranger.
So one of the dumb Oddworld lore things that's always bothered me.
Oh, please.
Let's get into this. Is that the Mudokons lost their like extra thumb between the first and second games.
Any reason for it?
I don't think so. I mean, it's never explained. In the first game, there's a part where like Abe is like reaching up at the sun and the sun, or not the sun, the moon, and the moon has like a big like Mudokon handprint thing on it or whatever.
Yeah.
And they have like a thumb and two fingers and then like a tiny little like vestigial thumb thing.
So are there any theories about that?
No, I think they just redesigned them. But it's just weird that they have like, it was just very conspicuous in the first game. So that like when the next game comes along and they don't have it, you're just like, there was an extra thumb there. The end. That's my story.
I have a theory for you, Joe.
Okay.
It might be far-fetched, but when we went on the infamous Second Son cover story, mm-hmm. they're talking about designing Sly Cooper and how they originally wanted him to have four fingers, but apparently that's a very bad sign in Japan to have four fingers because it's a sign of the Yakuza chopping off one of your fingers.
Okay.
So none of the idea was like cute mascot characters shouldn't have four fingers. And if they had four fingers for that entire race, maybe they wanted to appeal to the Japanese market lowering it down to three.
I don't think there's any confusing these like weird gangly alien looking dudes as like, you know, Yakuza thugs.
I don't know. They're humanoid, right? I think it could happen.
Yeah.
I think this is a sound theory, Ben.
Thank you. I'm sticking with my Yakuza theory.
Okay.
They're a part of the Oddworld mythology, I think.
Yeah, that's the next game. Is Abe's Yakuza Wars.
So Joe, I didn't bring you down here to have fun.
Okay, sorry.
I brought you down here because this game reminds me a little bit of BioShock.
Oh, really?
Picture this gun as the two hands of a character, of Booker or whoever in BioShock.
Okay.
So in the one, you have, like, your gun, right? Where you just have, like, your ammo that you're shooting. And then the other one could be used for, like, traps and stuff like that, right?
I think you're really stretching it here.
There's a crossbow in Burial at Sea, Episode 2.
I mean,
there's electricity.
So, but that means that it's just like any game that has guns and or powers in it.
Well, yeah, kind of. Yeah.
Okay.
But no. I mean, there's not many games where you have
this
like...
This really reminds me of Infamous, you know, where with like one hand you can kind of shoot some lightning and with the other hand you can like kind of throw grenades.
Quit making fun of me. I thought you would appreciate this. But no, I mean, how many games do you have one hand free and then the other one that has like a one that's like got a pistol and the other has like a power?
Well, actually, in the original BioShock, you can only use one at a time. So even though the hands did have powers, you weren't...
Turn off his microphone!
Hey, you guys want to hear something crazy?
Sure.
Speaking of larger mythologies.
Yeah.
BioShock Infinite. This is a stretch. But the creator of Gone Home, Steve Gaynor, at least the creative lead on that small team, he was talking about how technically Gone Home is within the BioShock universe because he snuck in this Easter egg where when you start out Gone Home, no spoilers, when you're sitting on the deck or like before you enter the house, you can see her luggage and she just got off the airplane. Apparently the airline is a 90s version of the logo from the airplane from the beginning of the first BioShock.
So he's getting sued and 2K is going to get all the money he made off the
Correct.
Game.
Correct.
No, yes. I mean, if I remember correctly, when that came up, the comment that he made about it is like, you know, it's maybe a little nod or an homage. It is definitely not connected in any kind of legally actionable way.
Please do not sue me.
Is sort of what he said. Yeah.
It's just vague enough.
Joe. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Here's like, and now it's not like a huge open world. It's mainly just this hub, right?
Yeah, it's about the size of like a Jack and Daxter type of hub.
Oh no, wait! Can you like plow into people and knock them over and stuff? Though I thought you could really troll people pretty good in this. Yeah, there we go.
That's the mark of a good game.
But then these guys just stand around and cluck.
That's right.
They're like, did you really just do that, dude?
And drop their money.
So the way the game's set up is you get... Okay.
You calm down. I think you look pretty calm.
You need to stop headbutting people.
Exactly. He's got to stop headbutting
really
chickens.
I'm so angry!
Open up your store!
Come on in, sir.
Open the store!
Yes. You seem much calmer. Please.
Joe, you got me in trouble. I can't continue the mission.
Take some responsibility.
Things could not be calmer.
I like the bounty store.
Did you make sure you talked to everybody when you came in town?
Okay, I think we're calm now.
Okay,
I think people are coming back out.
That's cool.
Right. God, one little headbutt. It's supposed to be a wild western town that can't handle one headbutt.
That was a pretty violent
headbutt.
There was
two of them, yeah.
All right,
look. I took his money, too.
All right.
And her money.
Hey, welcome to the bounty store.
Hey, you must be the guy. Those are Lorne Lanning voices. Out by the forest. Yeah, true. He's a nice guy if you guys ever get the chance to talk to him.
How many times do you think you've talked to Lorne Lanning in your life? Problem.
12, 13?
Ugh!
Is that like a jealous? It is.
It's crazy how long you've been in this industry.
Hanson
is mind-boggling.
Hanson's only talked to him 10 times.
I have talked to Lorne Lanning zero times.
He was hoping to come out of this one ahead.
No. I just think it's nuts. Like, oh yeah, that famous designer. Oh, I've talked to him, I don't know, 12 times. I haven't talked to my father 12 times.
No, okay, Hanson.
Okay, I'm taking a bounty, by the way, guys.
You've done lots of video interviews with lots of famous people, so.
Well, I don't like to brag.
Yeah, okay, well.
Okay, but so then never 12 times.
All right.
It's rare that I interview somebody twice. Like, it's always fun you go back to a studio that you've been to before and see how it's changed and stuff, but even that's pretty rare.
How many times have you talked to Todd Howard?
let's see. Twice? When we shot that Minecraft video, I don't think he was in a very talkative mood, so I don't know if that really counts. So 1.5 is probably what I'll say.
All right. Okay, yeah. So the mission I'm going to right now is going to be over here. Yeah, so this is the open world. Very nice looking.
Not bad.
Game still looks great.
Yeah. I do like the... Well, I mean, I do like the HD sort of polish that they put on it here. That helps.
And I'm a fan of any game where you can attack random people. That's one of the highlights of South Park, is just how almost everything is interactive in that game. You just go around destroying everything, attacking people endlessly.
That's my favorite game of the year so far.
Reiner, I'm with you. I saw that tweet, and I really appreciate it. It's like there's this second wave of people that are now finally getting around to finishing South Park.
Daniel, you want to add an asterisk to that comment?
Yeah, I'd like to note that Reiner has not played Dark Souls 2 yet.
That's exactly what I wanted you to say. Yeah. Okay, so...
Now, Reiner, you've played a little bit of it.
I played five hours, and I got made fun of for it.
Okay.
Because you chose Sorcerer.
I chose Sorcerer as my class.
What?
Oh, in that preview build.
But Daniel's giving me stink eye.
I mean, you know, hey.
Did he really pick Sorcerer?
Maybe next time try something that has to get up close to win.
Yeah.
I heard Sorcerer is more powerful in this one than the first one. Is that true?
No.
Okay. I didn't really hear that. I just wanted to sound smart.
Okay.
Okay, so I'm actually not... This game looks good, but I don't really like the visual style of it. Like those dumb looking chicken things don't really seem like they jive with the Scrags and the Mudokons and all that stuff from the Scrags.
You don't know that it's the same planet.
Well, it doesn't need to be the same planet. It's Oddworld. It's like there should be some sort of like cohesive visual style to it.
It seems odd enough to me. I think it's working. I don't know the series, but yeah, everything seems really out there.
I just don't like having to stare into that chipmunk's eyes as I'm wandering around the game.
Look at Jeff Goldblum
watching you poop.
When you get enough speed, look at this.
Wait, where did Jeff Goldblum watching you poop come from?
It's not important.
Is this like a fantasy of yours?
It's a famous meme. It clearly is.
Google it, you will see.
I'm not Googling that at work.
You will find a deep well of that meme.
I bet you've looked. You found plenty of of that stuff.
One time, I found a creepy picture of H.R. Geiger, and I printed it out, and I hung it up in the Game Informer bathroom, and I think it lasted 2 days before somebody ripped it down. It's like, all right, no more games. This is the sanctity of the bathroom, for God's sake.
Did you guys see me kill those guys with a boulder?
I did.
Is anybody paying attention?
I don't know. The whole Jeff Goldblum pooping thing was kind of off-putting.
Yeah, it kind
of
got us off track. Been looking for bolomites.
He's good for. What do you think of his voice? Outlaws.
I like the stranger voice.
About what you'd expect.
So
I really want to know this twist, you guys.
What do you think of the character design?
He's cool too. Everything seems okay.
We'll zoom in here.
He's like a little lion predatory.
Yeah, I think he looks cool.
Yeah. I'm bored. You know, Reiner, I think you're making him look worse. Oh, there we go. You know what your objective
well, wait,
is here,
wait, wait. Let's zoom in here one last time.
Are you just going for the crotch? Okay.
So that's how you get arrows off of your body.
Oh, when you take damage. Arrows lodged in you?
What? Really? That's a segue?
What?
Go ahead. Continue. What
you have arrows saying? Lodged in you, and they stay in you?
You do, and then you shake them out.
Oh, that's cool. I like that. Yeah. Like they stay in you.
I'll show that here in a second.
Now, this is one of those things. I think we've seen games since this sort of do it better, but like the sense of sort of like of speed that you have when you're the stranger and sort of doing that like that four-legged run, like you feel pretty cool and agile when that's going on.
Yeah, can you think of any other games that really do first to third person well? Obviously, the Elder Scrolls games have it, but nobody plays those games that way.
Fun fact.
Yes, they do.
Do you play third person?
I do.
There we go.
I always have.
Yeah. I play combat in those games first person, but I do exploration in third person.
Come on, guys.
It's weird. But Reiner, here's a weird fact. On the Skyrim trip, Todd Howard told us, bring it up Todd Howard again, that a majority of Americans play in first person, but a majority of Europeans play in third.
He told me that too.
He told me it louder though.
That was like I think he told me that the sixth time
God.
I talked to him.
Who do you think, who's the developer that you've interviewed the most or talked to the most?
Jason Rubin.
Is that just like outside of work stuff because you guys are kind of buddies?
Yeah, I mean, well, I guess interviewed for work.
I mean,
probably Todd Howard or...
Wow.
Okay.
I mean, I think Jason Rubin should still count just because he was like, just because he was at your wedding doesn't disqualify him as someone important. And...
Yeah, no, I guess so. The developer you know the best is Jason Rubin.
Yeah, but that was like after he was in the game and then he came back to the game.
Right. I would like to know what he's doing now.
Yeah, me too.
And now I'll just stare at you waiting for you to reveal some new secret.
I like it when you look at me like that.
Oh, that's nice.
Ben gets big stars in his eyes. Gets this big dopey grin on his face.
Mm-hmm. All right. I need some ammo. I'm not sure if I'm doing this right. Do you remember, Joe?
No, I mean, this is about as far into this game as I've played. So...
Is it annoying to have to constantly hunt down your ammo like that?
A little. I'm more annoyed by that chipmunk looking at me the entire time.
Yeah.
Oh, you can always just shoot him away if you don't want to look at him.
He looks a little bit like a Mogwai. Except without the ears.
Yeah, I can see that. Would you just blow this guy's mind if you just handed him an actual gun and bullets? Would it just completely... Could he take over this entire planet?
I'm in trouble, guys. I gotta get one of these guys down. Suck him up!
Wait, and you don't even get interrupted when you do that?
It's pretty nice.
Uh-oh.
Oh! Wow. A valiant attempt.
Second Triner. Yeah, this is tough. Like, the ammo doesn't reload right away. That's what you're saying. When I'm shooting just duds, it means it's not ready. Like, that animal's not ready for me to shoot yet. I'm going to try Bolomites.
Yeah, so is there any way to just sort of pick them off one by one by sucking them up, healing, and then going back in?
I didn't get Bolomites. I am a terrible gamer.
Yeah, the chipmunks aren't actually doing any damage.
Those guys just distract them.
Yeah.
Okay. Huh.
Should I just try to sneak around here?
So, Daniel, I would like to know how much of a PC snob you
now?
Are. I guess I don't know. Like, have you had consoles your entire life? Do you still play a lot of console games?
I don't play a ton of console anymore, but I'm certainly not like a console hater or PC elitist. I grew up on consoles and played PS1 and.
When did you
Xbox?
Make the shift fully over to PC?
Around PS2 era.
What led you over there?
Just great stuff coming out on PC all the time, and that's where. A lot of the online games like MOBAs and stuff like that, competitive RTSs,
okay,
stuff like that.
I mean, was there one game that you were like, man, I really need to just go to PC to play that?
It was probably like the original, like I guess, Blizzard games, like Warcraft and Starcraft were probably two of the huge reasons. And then Age of Empires 2, some of the other stuff that was really PC only and had huge online components.
See, I got all those knives out of me.
That's the best way to remove a knife. If you ever get stabbed in a bar, just beat your chest and it'll fall out of your body.
It works. I've tried.
Especially if you're stabbed in the chest.
Exactly.
All right, guys. What strategy should I use here? I do have these little bastards.
Find something in the environment and lead them to them with a squirrel and then destroy them with it.
Oh, Daniel's played this before.
I have not. I've watched... I mean, I figured there had to be a use for that ammunition, though.
Daniel, I picked out the second game just for you.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, you're gonna
love
it.
I'm scared.
No, you're gonna love it. It's everything you love in the world.
Really?
Yep.
Huh.
Did we get to see that?
No, we'll never see it.
See the game?
I guess what I'm saying is...
No, we're still playing this!
I'm sick of this.
Why? This is fun and great. You were raving about it.
Well, I was.
Look at that.
It faded fast.
The Mayfowler. What do you think of that, Hanson?
Yeah, boy.
Come on! You like puns and stuff like that?
Yeah, it's all cool.
Get this crap out of my body.
So, Reiner, how much of this game do you remember? Did you review it?
I did with Matt Miller. And you know what? It's really funny. When Miller and I reviewed it, we missed the tutorial screen where it told you that you could do this to remove stuff from your body.
Oh, wow.
So we thought it was just like this ridiculously hard, well-balanced game, like just for, you know, the ultimate gamer.
Oh, man.
We were like 3/4 of the way through the game when we figured out we could heal.
It has to be horrible.
Yeah, it was a terrible feeling.
Do you remember what you gave this game?
Yeah, like a 9, I think.
Wow.
I love it.
I definitely remember this game scoring high.
Were you here back then?
Was that one of those things then where you're at like the water cooler when I'm not around like talking? Like, jeez, I can't believe you gave it that score.
No, I mean, I was still fairly new at that point, I think. Because like, yeah, Matt Miller and I started at around the same time. He was just a couple months after me.
Oh, okay. And you guys were friends before you started.
Yep, yep, we knew each other from back in college.
And then when was your big falling out? When did that happen? When did you push your desk to the other side of the office?
Let's see. Well, that would be the legendary Culver's lunch of 03.
I have stories about that.
He demanded you needed more butter on your burger.
Yeah, I mean, I just wanted to get one hot fudge sundae, and he wanted more, and we fought, and it got ugly.
Yeah, I can see that becoming a problem real fast.
Yep. That's how it goes.
I would like you two to do a super replay together.
Oh, yeah?
I think it'd be really great. Mainly because Miller is rarely on mic here.
What should we play?
Oh, man.
God Hand?
What is your game? What is the game that you guys played in college together or whatever you guys did? Or whatever your dumb lives were like.
We played a lot of Amplitude.
Okay, well, look, that's not a horrible super. That's one of my favorite games of all time, and I admit that's a horrible super.
Hey, look at this. Okay, all the knives stayed.
We played some, I remember playing Zone of the Enders. I remember playing Metal Gear Solid 2, Devil May Cry. That was about that time.
All right.
Final Fantasy X.
We had a really good time doing that Zone of the Enders replay.
I was on that one.
Yeah, for sure. We did the Metal Gear Solid 2 demo after that.
Mm-hmm.
That'd be a good super replay someday. You should try to win a tournament or something, Jim.
Actually, Zone of the Enders would not be that bad. It's a pretty short game.
Yeah, that'd be a good one,
it's
actually.
Like 6 or 7 hours, I think.
I still have to play the second one. Uh-oh. I never got around to that.
Second one has the distinction of having one of the worst named main characters of all time.
Please, who is it?
The main character in Zone of the Enders 2 is Dingo Egret.
I love it.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Oh, no, I saved the day.
You showed up. I thought we were done for.
Well, it looks like them outlaws have blocked the road to town.
I would yell at this guy just to speak like a normal human.
Stinky bastards got us good this
talk
time.
Faster.
Just talk faster. Stop breathing so much.
Stop being so ponderous.
You're not as cool as you think, tall lion.
When you put it like that, that sounds kind of awesome. Tall lion and
oh my god!
What?
This game just got vicious, real fast.
Lloyd, I'm taking you in, alive or a corpse.
Okay.
It's your choice.
Do we get it?
Looks like we got company, boys.
I guess it is kind of the fun part about this world, is it seems cute and then it gets weird and violent. Like in the first game, you could like take over people's minds and then like hold it down enough that they exploded.
That's
and then
true.
Abe would laugh every time they would explode.
And
there was farting, which was just grotesque.
It does get like strangely blood and guts.
Yeah. Plus, I guess they're turning Abe's whole race into food in the first game too.
Yeah.
Which...
Well, no, but you're right. I mean, the series definitely has it kind of like a little bit of like a Saturday morning cartoon vibe, except people just like die horribly.
There's some very grim undertones going on here. I don't know much about the whole series, but yeah, it's a strange mix.
That's probably what was kind of fun, like as a kid playing. It's like it seems like it was made for you, and it's just like, oh, cartoony world. And it's like, oh wait, no, this is actually more adult than I thought. What is going on with that guy?
He's getting bit by the little Furby.
Oh. Now I'm just wailing on his butt.
Oh, man. Remember Furbies? I forgot that was a thing.
One time.
I don't want to hear it.
Yeah, one time.
I don't want to hear about Jeff Goldblum and Furbies.
Oh.
Don't get me started.
I'm going to cheese this guy. Oh, no. I got dizzy.
So one time in sixth grade, when Furbies were all the craze for us, we all had them, you know?
Those were popular when you were in sixth grade?
Yes.
Let's try not to think about that.
That was the peak. Okay. Don't try and do the math.
Okay.
Anyways, so we all had them, and the teacher had to confiscate them. And she's like, that's it. I'm taking all these Furbies and putting them all in this cupboard together. Okay. We're like, I don't think you want to do that.
Oh.
And so she put them all in the cupboard together, and they interact with each other. So the cupboard was just like, too late, blah, blah, blah. Just this crazy cacophony of Furby noise as they got closer together.
You distracted me, dude. That Sorry. Was crazy.
I'm sure it was very cool.
It was the Furby closet that got you.
I could be wrong, but I don't think Third Triner has
Come
the
on!
Same awesome ring to it.
That was a crazy Furby story.
I like that. I'm going to start calling you Third Triner.
Yeah, Third Triner's a charm.
You guys suck. So that's Oddworld Stranger's Wrath. It still looks good on HD. I highly recommend you play it if you haven't, but not before playing the first two Abe's games if you're new to the series. Those are definitely the best ones. And I think, Hanson, this is coming to the current consoles, right?
No, the first one is.
The new Apes game. Okay.
Yeah, yeah. So definitely play that. And if you like that, this is a good way to continue.
Yep, and this is on PlayStation 3, and I believe Xbox 360 is digital download. Let's move on to Roulette and Daniel's game.
My name is Bab. This is my life.
Damn it! I write my music the way I want to! F*** you! Stop booing me! Go! Drive! 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 Drive!
This is how I lived. What is the measure of a man? I don't know.
Jimmy, get the f*** out of here!
Running down his dream. Wondering how long it's gonna take. Diplomats. Bureaucrats. I don't know how the story ends. You don't.
Mom, I can't believe it. You're a legend. How many times must a man look up before he can see the sky? How many ears must one man have before he can hear people cry? And how many deaths will it take till he knows too many people have died? The answer, my friend, is blowing the other wind. The answer is blowing the other wind. The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer.
Just for you, Daniel. You're going to like it.
We'll see.
I was at home eating a bowl of Lucky Charms.
I already like it.
And I started thinking of you, and I was like, you know what? I wonder if Daniel's ever played Lost Kingdom. There's two of these. That shows that this game was really good. It got a sequel.
Mm-hmm.
And it's, you know who it's developed by?
I think we just saw it on the screen.
I'm not sure. Who is it?
From Software. I'm looking Daniel right in the eyes.
I'm extremely interested.
I'm not looking at the screen.
This is back when they were a quality developer. Oh, what?
Did you skip
the
that?
Whole beat?
I kind of did, yeah.
All right.
Do we want to see the intro?
No.
No, it's fine.
Unless you're really jonesing for some action.
Well, yeah, I'm really looking to get into this.
Wow.
You know, I'm excited.
But the reason I picked it up for you is because you get the name Katia.
Katia is fine.
Whoa, 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 whoa. No, whoa, 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 whoa.
Put in the butts. Put in the butts.
Butts with a Z, dude.
You guys still do that?
Yeah. Come on, Joe.
All right. I mean, I'm all for hilarious names, but... Maybe I just don't like it because I think it was...
No!
Joke. No, no, no. Bus is good. Bus is good.
Bus with a Z, please.
Yeah, you got it.
Daniel, right, I'm not going to invite you on this show anymore if you keep doing this.
All right. Well, I think I got it right.
But anyway, I picked it for you because it's a card game, and I know you love those. Right?
You've been playing...
This is true.
You're a big, Hearthstone fan, right?
I'm a fan of most of the major TCGs.
Like, he would review individual cards for Forbes. Like, he'd write, like... paragraphs for like an individual
What about the four
card.
Of spades? How would you review that?
I give it a 4.
Oh, come on.
I see. I get it.
But it's also like a straight up action game where you're using the cards as your attacks. So you make a deck and then you have to like put down a plant creature to take out some other creatures. You put down like an ogre.
Sure. It's not a complete...
You don't sound enthused!
Hey, you know, that's been done before, and these can go either way. So I'm kind of curious to see how this, this has been done.
Interesting question here, Joe. I'm going to deem my own question interesting.
Okay.
If I were to have closed your eyes, opened it now, you can only look at the screen, could you guess which console this is on?
No.
Really?
Uh-uh.
Doesn't it just... I think it really looks like a GameCube-ass GameCube game.
I mean,
it is a GameCube game.
It is literally a GameCube game. Yeah,
both of them are on GameCube.
Maybe it's just the slightly bubbly character designs, but relatively crisp.
Yeah, I guess I probably couldn't. Maybe the text boxes. If there were a text box up, I think I'd probably be able to guess it then.
So there's no real indicator of where I'm supposed to go here.
Oh, just go anywhere. It's like Dark Souls,
oh,
man.
Okay.
It's freedom.
It's all from software. Did you talk to that guy?
Okay, so it's open world, and if I go anywhere, I'm going to die. All right.
Play a card.
Also, it looks like you have a wing, so if you can fly somewhere... Anywhere but a card battling table, you should do that.
Hmm.
Reiner, so you've played this before?
Yeah.
Did you review this?
I loved it.
Wow.
I love how Reiner's like, oh, I was eating cereal. And I'm like, I wonder if Daniel's ever played... What's this?
That's exactly what happened.
Yeah. Who... Like, the bigger question is, like, I wonder if anyone has ever played Lost Kingdom.
Come on, dude. It's from software.
It's
what have they gone wrong?
It cannot be bad.
Oh.
Dark Souls, man.
Uh-oh. Yeah. Uh-oh.
But what about every game prior to Dark Souls?
You got to admit, those are really cool-looking skeletons.
They are. And it looks like we get to fight them.
Good luck putting a card down in front of them.
Come on, guys.
Got to give it a chance, guys.
All right.
Yeah. That's
here we go. I got some bird thing, it looks like.
All right.
Daniel, do you think you're only into card games because of Magic the Gathering? Was that your first?
It certainly wasn't my first, but it was the first major one. There were a lot of card games.
What about like Yu-Gi-Oh?
Pokemon?
I've played both those games.
There we go.
Okay, so but why did you skip that?
I didn't skip it.
We get it.
He's reading.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm reading.
Those are on
the
different buttons. You see that?
I got it. So cards are different buttons, and I can lay them out.
Oh, weird. Oh. Wait, what?
Ha ha ha. And see, it's got a burn.
Right.
So some of them become you, and other ones become stationary creatures you put down.
I am so confused right now, but I'll figure it out.
I think this looks cool.
It's awesome.
I take back everything I've said.
I can't really figure out what's going on.
So the plant creatures are slower than the skeletons. So the skeletons are really working them.
Okay, so I summoned some stuff and I killed the skeletons, I think.
Well, one skeleton.
And then you get Zenny for it.
Oh, good. I like Zenny.
Okay, good. Man traps.
Have you seen other games like this where a card actually becomes your attack on your character?
They're out there, although if you asked me to name them, I couldn't right now.
What about Kingdom Hearts Chain of Memories?
I have not played that.
Isn't that just laying down cards? Well, no, you do get attack cards, right?
Yeah. I guess I don't know about the summoning aspect of it.
Hey, Joe.
Yeah.
Do you remember how weird it was in the first Kingdom Hearts when Sephiroth was voiced by Lance Bass?
No.
Isn't that weird?
I haven't played through the first Kingdom Hearts. I don't know.
I haven't either, but I just remember seeing that when it was coming out and being like, what in the world? Sephiroth? The coolest character?
I mean,
this does seem like it could be kind of cool.
Does Haley Joel Osment still voice Sora?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's all he does.
But as Dan Reichert once said, he's now 74 years old. That really made me laugh. Okay, we got a castle.
Come on, I want you guys to be in this.
Yeah,
you're taking me to a dark spot. Dark, dark place.
Okay. Well, I mean, help us be happy about this, Reiner, because like, there's a lot of text that's not, and it's not really well explained, and there's been like 5 seconds of actual gameplay.
See,
I think this shows promise.
Yeah, Daniel.
I'm moving into this as fast as possible, but you know, with any kind of game with cards, there's usually a lot of introduction, a lot of stuff you have to plow through.
Why are you laughing at the loading
screen?
Thank
God they animated that loading screen. That's the weirdest animation ever. Who's this bamboo?
I don't know. He said, like, you know, be careful. There's goblins. So we're going to go fight some goblins.
He said that?
He did.
Wow.
Gerd? My trusty Gerd.
Okay, that's funny.
All right, here we go. We're going to fight something.
So
just wandering towards the mountain.
So right now, I believe the combat sequences are isolated in these kind of little dioramas. But
right.
Later in the game, I think it's just in the overworld.
Did they fart?
Okay, so you're my... Oh, okay, no, he's still there.
Some of them, like, come out and actually move around. Others are just an attack executed by your character.
Right. How are you supposed to know that? It seems like it's very important.
I'm sure it's indicated on the card, but we haven't figured that out. Like,
And there's over 100 cards, Daniel.
Over
100? It's a pretty good deck.
Daniel, you're fired if you don't take this game home tonight. I hope you realize what's going on here.
You have to write a book or a game report on, I keep forgetting the name, Lost Kingdom?
Okay. So memorable.
This is the last time I ever do anything nice for anyone.
Oh, man.
You ruined my daughter's life.
I'm having a lot of
what?
Fun.
Hideo. Here they come.
Look at that.
It looks like the fairy from Blue Stinger.
So that fairy heals your monsters, I think.
Right. It's too bad it was the only one I had out. Okay, see, here's how it works. See those little swords on the icons? They're like an attack we do.
Okay.
So when if it's a little red beastie thing, I think they come out and attack. But we didn't get any in this draw, so we're kind of in trouble.
There you go.
So if you burn through a card, does it just go away?
It goes away,
and you get a new one.
See, that one's going to
summon.
You get a
new one, but your deck is limited.
Summon it. Let's see it.
But your deck is limited, so you could get yourself in a
really
bad position.
You can run out of all your cards.
Exactly.
Interesting.
Oh, so it's not like you don't get to like shuffle the discard pile or whatever.
No, I think it said once you use a card, it's gone. So
it's a little bit like Paper Mario sticker card.
So like that big guy I just summoned, he was like really strong, right? But I only got to use him once.
Mm-hmm.
But do they recharge after battle?
I think they just go away.
Daniel, am I allowed to assign features for you to write?
Oh, yeah.
Is
sure.
that how the system works?
That's how it works.
Mm-hmm. Because I would love to read a complete history of From Software, because they are a weird company that have been around for a long time.
That's not a bad idea.
That sounds pretty interesting.
They have done so many weird projects, and then just pretty late in their lives.
I don't think as many as you thought. They've done some. I don't think it's as expansive as you think. Like, they've made a bunch of Kingsfield games.
Yeah.
They do
Armored Core, right?
They did Armored Core.
Metal Wolf Chaos, which is a game we have to play, where you play as the American president driving this awesome mech.
What, for real?
Yes, it's an awesome game.
Okay, that sounds awesome.
I think it was only released in Japan.
It's actually like no joke.
We're actually going to replay that one.
Yeah, no, we definitely should.
Yeah,
I'd love to see it.
That's a candidate for a super replay for end of the year.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
That game is super weird.
It is super weird, and it screams Dan Reichert, so...
But that was me maybe doing something nice, but now I don't know.
Oh, Christ.
Next replay, Pac-Man.
Uh-huh.
Next replay after that, Ms. Pac-Man.
So
I'm not doing anything fun anymore.
Just keeping the fun down to as low as possible.
Yeah, Dig Dug. We're going way back with replay.
We're going way back.
I don't know. I don't like the implication that those games aren't fun.
Yeah, Ms. Pac-Man.
They're fun,
still
but you don't want to watch them for like 30 minutes unless you're playing them,
okay,
right?
Okay, so we can throw cards away, too.
I don't want to watch Lost Kingdom.
Come on!
This game is awesome.
Joe, you're the RPG nerd, and even you were like, no go.
This game is at least awesome in theory, if not execution.
It's pretty cool, right?
Yeah.
See?
This could have been an amazing game.
I have a friend.
Okay, are these hobgoblins farting? Is that what's going on? There's a big like green cloud.
Yeah,
they're
super farty.
They're attacking. That's what we call it.
All right.
We'll do one more battle, then we'll get Daniel's take on it.
And the official review.
And all you
other guys.
We're going to go back and change our previous review.
It's a new segment called Tax Take.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I like that.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
We came up with Chronicle for his video thing, but maybe we'll change that to Tax Take.
Could be.
It's the boss.
Mm-hmm.
The boss of the goblins.
No, this will be a good fight to end with.
Tax Day?
Nope.
Joe.
It didn't work.
Yeah, well, it's not as great. Joe, you once said the most mind-boggling thing to me, where you said that you've just played so many RPGs now, if an RPG just seems overwhelmingly complicated, you love it so much more right out of the gate, because you know that it's a challenge you have to tackle, which is just crazy to me. Because
that's true. Like one of my favorites is Valkyrie Profile, which is pretty complicated, I'd say. Or like Xenosaga is another one. I think that is like on the scale of like how deep RPGs go. I think those are some of the deepest ones of the PS1, PS2 era.
So you're never turned off by complexity when you start a game. You're never just like, oh, what a bummer, another menu. What is this crap?
Not in an RPG, no.
Daniel's in trouble.
I don't have any more cards.
Yeah, you should have used one of those portals to get more.
Oh, yeah, that would have been a good idea.
What do you do now?
Your plant might. Oh no, the plant's dead.
No, so I have no cards.
Yeah, you're totally screwed.
Just wait till they fall asleep.
So you just die here?
Yeah, you have to die.
Now see, that's very From Software.
You can always jump off into the
There is no forgiveness. If you run out of cards, you're just dead.
Yeah.
Wow.
See?
I like it. I like it
what
already.
What do you think, Daniel? Seriously, give me your honest opinion on your first 15 minutes.
In all seriousness, I'd keep playing this after 15 minutes. Okay. It does seem like it could be, with only like 100 cards, it doesn't seem like it could be that interesting, but it's probably not a very long game.
Daniel, correct me if I'm wrong, but I see a little smirk of a smile coming up on the side of your mouth.
Sure.
Wow.
Why not?
A smirk is a smile.
It has over 20 hours of gameplay, according to the box. Those never lie.
That's true.
And there was a sequel, which means this one was awesome.
It does mean that.
Therefore, I was right, and that's the end of Replay. We'll see you next week, everyone.